Welcome to, or welcome back to, the 510 Report, where we talk about industry news, advocacy, and general goings on. Thank you so much for joining me for this special report. The FDA, Scott Gottlieb and the FDA have officially gone off of the rails. The vape industry and vapers in general have officially been threatened by the FDA. So Scott Gottlieb, the commissioner of the FDA, went on the PBS NewsHour show, and in regards to e-cigarettes and vaping, he said this: "We have access to data that demonstrates to us there is nothing short of an epidemic of use among teenagers, which is really interesting to me because the CDC reports that youth vaping rates among high schoolers has only increased 1.5% between 2011 and 2016. CDC doesn't report much data after that, but I can hardly think that 1.5% of high schoolers have used an e-cigarette in the last 30 days would be called an epidemic." The CDC also reports that middle school student e-cigarette use, meaning they've tried an e-cigarette within the last 30 days, rose to 0.6% between 2011 and 2016. Epidemic? Really? The CDC also reports that between 2011 and 2016, there's been almost a 16% decrease in high school tobacco use. And between 2011 and 2016, there has been a 4.3% decrease among middle school students using traditional tobacco combustible cigarettes. So if anything, I mean, just thinking rationally, the epidemic that we have is young people quitting smoking. Quitting smoking with a product that is at least 95% healthier for you. And we all kind of know that that 95% less harmful for you bullet point comes from the Royal College of Physicians, but the Royal College of Physicians aren't the only organization touting the health benefits of vaping. Let's take a look at what some other health organizations are saying about vaping. And a huge thank you to Charles A. Gardner, PhD, for posting this on Twitter. The U.S. National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine say while e-cigarettes are not without health risks, they are likely to be far less harmful than combustible tobacco cigarettes. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration themselves say, make no mistake, we see the possibility for ENDS products like e-cigarettes to provide a potentially less harmful alternative for currently addicted individual adult smokers who still want to get access to satisfying levels of nicotine without many of the harmful effects that come with the combustion of tobacco. The American Cancer Society says, based on currently available evidence, using current generation e-cigarettes is less harmful than smoking cigarettes. The American Association of Public Health Physicians say smokers unable or uninterested in quitting should consider switching to a less hazardous smoke-free tobacco nicotine product, including nicotine replacement therapy, electronic cigarettes, snus, other forms of moist snuff, and chewing tobacco. Royal College of Physicians, available data suggests that e-cigarette health risks are unlikely to exceed 5% of those associated with smoking tobacco products and may well be substantially lower. In the UK, harm reduction is a recognized element of a comprehensive tobacco control. E-cigarettes are effective in helping people to stop smoking. There are as yet no identified health risks from secondhand vapor. British Medical Association, there were clear potential benefits to e-cigarette use in reducing the substantial harms associated with smoking and a growing consensus that they are significantly less harmful than tobacco use. The British Lung Foundation, there's more evidence than ever that e-cigarettes are safer than smoking and a way to give up altogether. Swapping cigarettes for an e-cig can improve your symptoms of lung conditions like asthma and COPD. Public Health England, our new review reinforces the finding that vaping is a fraction of the risk of smoking, at least 95% less harmful of a negligible risk to bystanders. Standards. Yet over half of smokers either falsely believe that vaping is as harmful as smoking or just don't know. But wait, there's more. Cancer Research UK, evidence so far indicates that e-cigarettes are far less harmful than tobacco and may help smokers to cut down or quit. We do not believe there is justification for an indoor ban, either on the basis of potential harm to bystanders from secondhand vapor or that they re-normalize smoking. The Royal Society for Public Health endorses new Public Health England report reflecting up-to-date evidence that is increasingly pointing in the same direction. Not only is vaping at least 95% less harmful than smoking, but is also helping increasing numbers of smokers to quit. The government of Canada says vaping is less harmful than smoking. Adults can now legally get vaping products with nicotine as a less harmful option than smoking. Switching from tobacco cigarettes to vaping products will reduce a person's exposure to many toxic and cancer-causing chemicals. The Truth Initiative themselves. Some smokers may be unable or unwilling to quit using nicotine and would benefit by completely switching to a much lower harm nicotine delivery mechanism, including potentially a well-regulated e-cigarette. And there are more. There are much, much more. So with all due respect, Mr. Gottlieb, what we have isn't an epidemic of youth vaping. What we have is an epidemic of misinformation coming from you and the FDA. What we have is an epidemic of adult smokers finally being able to quit smoking using e-cigs and vaping. What we have is an epidemic of doctors and scientists and health groups and governments all praising the benefits of vaping. So Scott Gottlieb on Wednesday announced a major crackdown on retailers who are possibly selling vapor products to underage children, underage youths, which in my opinion is a completely reasonable thing to do. If someone walks into a convenience store and buys a Juul and the person behind the counter doesn't card them, then that establishment and the person behind the counter should definitely, definitely get in trouble. The same laws that we have in place for vaping right now, 18 and over or 21 and over in some states, are the same laws that they have for tobacco cigarettes, 18 and over or 21 and over in some states. And this 18 and over or 21 and over laws that we have in the United States has been satisfactory for tobacco cigarettes. If you don't have your ID, you can't buy cigarettes. If you don't have your ID, you can't buy vapor products. Scott Gottlieb is also going after the manufacturers of the vapor products. Scott Gottlieb doesn't want to just keep the retailers in check. He wants to keep the manufacturers in check and hold them accountable for what's going on, which, mind you, is something that is essentially completely out of their control. Juul Labs has no control over whether the retailer that they are selling to, whether that's a CVS or a Rite Aid or a 7-Eleven or a vapor shop, if one of those establishments isn't carding the people that come in to buy the vape gear, then again, that's the responsibility of that particular establishment. And essentially, the threat that Scott Gottlieb put out there was, manufacturers, you either need to find a way to keep young people from getting your products, or we're gonna shut this all down. We're gonna shut down the entire vapor industry and nobody gets to vape. And just to play devil's advocate a little bit here, and again, this is certainly not a, we're getting in trouble so we should get them in trouble as well, but do we hold every alcohol manufacturer responsible when someone underage drinks and drives and possibly injures themselves or kills somebody else? Where exactly does the blame lie? If the blame does actually lie with the manufacturers, then this is something that we need to adopt across the board. We need to hold cigarette manufacturers responsible for cancer. We need to hold alcohol manufacturers responsible for alcoholism. Or if the responsibility lies with the retailer who's actually doing the selling of these products to underage people, maybe the responsibility lies with them. And yes, I do realize that there is a lot of social responsibility from these vapor companies as well. And things like questionable branding, bad labels, IP theft. These are things that a lot of us in the vape industry have been fighting against for years now. So I do understand that there does need to be some social responsibility from a lot of these vape manufacturers. But the scapegoat that the FDA chose was Juul. And look at Juul's packaging. It is the most adult-oriented branding and packaging that I have ever seen. It's mostly black and white. There are very few colors on it. There's no cartoon characters, there's no googly eyes on it. They don't name their flavors weird things like unicorn puke. Juul only has 8 flavors in their lineup, 2 of which are tobaccos, 2 of which are menthols, 1 is cucumber. I genuinely find it hard to believe that kids would be attracted to a cucumber flavor. They also have mango and fruit, as opposed to something like candy, marshmallow, sugar, fruit blast. I get the sneaking suspicion that this is how the FDA is going to go after flavors. And what Scott Gottlieb is essentially telling the industry is, figure out why people like flavors so much, or we're gonna take your flavors away. The United States, led by the FDA, is one of the last few countries on earth that have yet to embrace tobacco harm reduction through vapor products. All it's doing is making us look foolish and backwards. The UK, utilizing vapor products as a form of tobacco harm reduction, hopes that the whole country will be smoke-free by 2024. That's their goal. It seems as though the FDA's goal is to completely shut down vaping by 2022. And one last thing that was really interesting that came out of this, as soon as Scott Gottlieb announced his big crackdown on vape manufacturers, tobacco stocks surged. CNBC reported, shares of Altria rose nearly 7% to their best day since November 2008. Philip Morris International increased about 3%. British American Tobacco shares increased nearly 6% to their best day since December 2008. In London, Imperial Brands rose 3%. Only our ass-backward government could make a statement condemning the use of vaping and then see tobacco stocks soar. Just by making that statement, Scott Gottlieb helped Big Tobacco. Mr. Scott Gottlieb, the science is there, and by telling people otherwise, you are doing a great, great disservice to public health. Youth smoking and vaping rates are at the lowest they have ever been. Many other countries across the globe are embracing vapor products as a form of tobacco harm reduction, with their goal being smoke-free societies. But of course, in sensationalist and fear-mongering United States, vaping is the enemy, and Big Tobacco now suddenly seems to be the hero. I mean, otherwise, why would Scott Gottlieb help them out so much? And that's where I'm going to leave this 510 report. As always, I'd love to get your thoughts down in the comments below. Also, don't forget to join CASA. It's free and easy and effective. Follow those calls to actions. And as Kevin Skipper always said, you don't have to do everything, but you do have to do something. Let's get involved.